Okay, so today I have a very interesting personality, Arpit Rungta. He has been my student at DCA Institute's GMCS classes, so that's where I met him. And over the years, when I followed his career, I realized that he branched off to photography from CA Inter. So welcome to the show, Arpit, and it will be great to hear your journey. So tell me something, like, you are from a business family. What business does your family do? And then how did you stumble upon the CA world?
So my family is into manufacturing of artificial leather, which you can call as leatherite or rexin, which is used in footwear industry or car seat covers, or maybe like on sofa seats also. And I knew that I'm not made for business. I don't understand business. So I was like, okay, I don't need to get into this thing. I need to start something which is different or which is not of a business field. Because today also I don't understand business. So I was like, okay, let's get into CA. Because in class 11 and 12, there was nothing as such, like there was no counseling as such. So for commerce students, either we had CS, or cost accounting, and then later on MBA. These were the only options that we were aware of. We had no other idea only that what are the other fields of, like,
absolutely.
Yeah.
There is no information. So that's where exactly. A YouTube channel like mine comes into play, where I at least make some effort on this count. So how did you buy the CA form? I heard that your friends.
Yeah. So basically what happened, in class 11, I remember few of my friends went to CA Institute to buy the CPT form. And they just called me from there that, okay, Arpit, do you need a CPT form? I was like, okay, how much is it for? They're like, it is for 650 rupees. I was like, okay, buy it. Everyone is doing CA. I was like, okay, let's try CA. And my father, before submitting the form, my father questioned me at least 5 times that, are you sure that you're going to pursue CA? Because as far as I know you, Arpit, you are not going to do it.
So then you cleared CPT and...
CPT was cleared in my first attempt, and my class 12 results were horrendous as in comparison to any other CBSE student. So clearing CPT in the first go was like an achievement for me and for my family.
And then you went into CA IPCC, and that's where the struggle started. So you cleared group one?
Yeah, I cleared my group one in my third attempt, and then I joined articleship. I was giving both groups at the same time. I was not doing like one group in 6 months. I was not doing that. I was appearing for both the groups all the time. So third attempt, I only cleared my group one. And after that, I joined articleship. I was kind of a regular article at my office. I did not join through any so-called source or so-called reference as such. Because my father told me, like, my father has huge contacts. Like, he told me that I cannot talk to any company because you have not cleared both the groups.
Oh, yeah.
Like, okay, no problem. I'll figure it out. So I figured out something, and then I joined a firm. And I was regular somehow. And then since I need to give my exams of IPCC Group 2 also, so I had to take leaves, and I appeared for my group 2 exams for at least 9 times, and then I left IPCC. I was like, I'm not going to do it anymore, because if IPCC is going to take, for example, say 9 attempts, I don't know how much time will CA final take from me.
So what was the roadblock then? ITSM?
Yeah, ITSM was the main roadblock, and I used to get I've acquired single digit marks also, and the highest that I got was 34 or 35.
Okay.
The other two subjects like accounts and audit, I used to get above 40, above 50, close to 60, but not 60. and ITSM used to be a weak point for me, but I still don't understand why ITSM can be a weak point for me, since I was the one of the toppers in computer in class 10.
But probably the memory element here, one, the memory element, and maybe you would not have learned the 6 points in the order in which they are mentioned in the study material, because that's where the examiner also looks at those specific 6 headings and otherwise doesn't give you a mark. Probably.
I don't know. I have stopped thinking about it. I have left that part now. It has. Yeah, I gave my last attempt in, I think, November 2016. That was my last attempt.
So that's, I know, I suddenly saw that Facebook page of yours, Arpit Rungta Photography. And so how did photography happen in your life? You know, once CA was not happening, people would have said, Arpit, padha karo yaar, theek se padhte kyon nahi ho? Something like that happened?
I'm not a very bright student since childhood. I was a mediocre or like jaise taise pass hone wala student. So my parents knew ki bhai theek hai, koshish kar raha, he's trying, so let him try. I tried my best, but it did not happen. Plus, CA was always my backup plan. I always wanted to get into photography. Photography was my passion. Now it is passion turned into profession. And yeah, that's
passion as in school and all. Class.
Yeah, so basically I was gifted my first camera when I was in class 4. And from then I had a knack into photography and all. In class 11 and 12 I was the school's official photographer. I am from Bharati Vidya Bhavan, Salt Lake, Kolkata. Okay. So in class 11 and 12 I was the official photographer for the school. My classmates used to tease me because I used to click a lot of photographs and all, and sometimes it was depressing, but later on I was like, okay, I don't need to think about it because this is who I am. And after that, after class 12, then in college first year, because of CPT and IPCC, photography was somewhat at a standstill. Then again in 2012, like in 2011 I passed class 12, in 2012 again I somehow started photography again. I took part in a Facebook competition organized by some magazine, and it was like a fashion photography competition, and it was like you get the maximum number of likes and you'll get £1,000, and that photograph will be featured in their magazine. So at that time I was not into fashion photography, so what do? I was into nature and wildlife. So, okay, so I was thinking like, okay, what should I do? Then I remembered that I have a photograph clicked of my hot cousin. So I submitted that particular photograph and I lost by 21 likes. And that particular competition's result made me venture into fashion photography. I was initially rejected by 77 girls saying that, okay, you're not paying us as a model. You don't have a DSLR. You don't have a professional camera. You don't have experience. You don't have a studio. I was like, okay, no problem. Every dog has its day. So somehow few friends helped me in getting clicked by me. And I became famous overnight in my college. I studied from Bhavanipur College. And after that, many more people came in to get photo shoots done and all. And that time, I was not thinking it from a commercial point of view. Then one of my school friend who knew marketing and all, he was studying in St. Xavier's. His name is Saket Mehrotra. He told me that, why don't you start charging? It's like, how should I charge? I don't know how to charge. So he's like, okay, you charge a bare minimum amount that the person can really afford it. Then you increase it later on, however you want. So in 2013, on Saraswati Puja, I remember, I charged 250 rupees per person for unlimited photographs, and I had like 6 clients in one day. So I was like, okay, 1500 rupees aa gaye. And so then I started charging people. Then I bought a professional camera, like an entry level professional camera. And at my house, it was, my parents were very strict. Like my mom was still okay, but my dad is still strict. And he's like, no, camera nahi kharidna and all. And I told him that, okay, I'm not asking for money. I have my savings, I'll buy a second-hand camera. And then he was like, okay, no problem. I did not buy a second-hand camera. I bought a new camera. I had 15,000 rupees as savings, and the camera costed 32,000. So I took 17,000 as loan and advance from friends and clients that, okay, I'll return you, or I'll do a photo shoot after buying the camera. And from friends, I took a loan of say around 12,000, and I told them that, okay, I'm going to repay you in 3 months. In 1.5 months, my loan repayment was done. The advance was serviced, and yeah, that's how it all started.
Oh my God, this is fantastic.
My dad still doesn't know that it is not a second-hand camera. And that, yeah, that's how it all started.
Okay, so then, but then there would be a lot of people who would be saying, "Arey yar, Arpit, paise mat do yar, paise kya chiz ke le rahe ho?" And so you would have that monetization. Then, so any good thing in life, when you monetize, the real challenge comes. You know, people really start saying, "Arey, paise."
So my main thinking is not generating money, it is more about generating clients. So if I capture one client by charging less money or maybe no money, and if I am giving a quality job, that person, even later on, if he replaces me, he's not going to get the same quality job. Ultimately, he is going to come to me.
Yeah, that's a good strategy. So foot in the door is okay, free maybe, but then give them a flavor of your work. So then they know the difference between the grain and the chef.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
That's nice. So then how did you scale up? Means from there, how was the journey then getting into Bollywood and all that?
Yeah. So my main idol used to be Dabu Ratnani. He is a celebrity photographer in Bombay. And I did a workshop of Dabu sir. In 2016 only, he came to Calcutta. He was a part of Nikon photography school. So I'm a Nikon user, and I got a call from Nikon that, okay, he is coming. He's going to do a workshop. If you want to join, this is the process. I was like, okay, fine, no problem. I went to his workshop, and I did not quite understand too much of what he was trying to say. I was like, okay, no problem. Maybe some other time. Then it was in August, I remember. It was 16th or 17th of August. I clearly remember. Then on 25th of September, he organized another workshop in Bombay. And I was like, okay, I need to go here because this seems important. And at that time, I did not have money to rather book tickets or like pay for it or whatever you call it. So I asked money from my dad, and he was like, "Tum 7,500 rupees ka workshop ke liye 40,000 rupees lagayega kya?" I was like, "I need to do it. I cannot think that okay, if I'm spending say 7,500 on the workshop and I'm spending a lot more on the travel and the stay, I don't care about that. I need to attend this workshop." So a total of 89 people participated in this workshop, and I was the only person who was not from Bombay. So he recognized me because he saw me a month ago, because I had personal interaction with him. I wanted to assist him. His staff members recognized me because we shared contact details of each other. And so yeah, that was a good start for me. In 2016 only in November, that was my last attempt because I did not want to continue with CA anymore. Because once I went to Bombay, I knew what photographers really are in Bombay. In Calcutta at that time, maybe I did not know how to market myself, or maybe people did not value me then. But after getting a stamp of Bombay, everything changed. So I left CA, and then after leaving CA, I'm from a very conservative family. So my grandmother told me one thing, that since you're a BCom honors only, you won't get a girl to marry, you won't get a job worth 10,000 rupees also. So if your interest is in photography, just get a degree in photography. So I did a lot of research work and all, and I found out that only Symbiosis School of Photography in Pune, they offer a degree in photography. I applied there. I went there. I got selected. I went for the interview. I showed my portfolio, and the interviewing panel, they told me, I think you have filled up the wrong form. You should have filled up the faculty form because you already know stuff. You can teach stuff. I walked off. I was like, okay, I'm not going to stay here. I walked off. I called up my dad and I was like, I'm going to Bombay from here directly. I need to chill for 3-4 days. I need to party for 3-4 days. And he's like, okay, no problem. Whatever you feel is good. I was like, okay, fine. I went to Bombay. It was my last day in Bombay. And I get a message from a lady that she is looking for a fashion photographer for 40 days. And it was 5 a.m. in the morning. And I am a person who is usually awake at that time. Like, I usually get up early. I replied instantly. And this is the same girl who organized a workshop with Dabu Ratnani in Bombay. So I replied, and then she was like, okay, show me your studio stuff, what you have and all, studio lights, what all soft boxes, what all modifiers do you have. I just sent her a picture because I had it in my phone. So she was like, okay, you're on board. And later on, after 2-3 days, I get to know that this is for Namrata Soni School of Makeup and Hair. Those who don't know about Namrata Soni, she has been awarded as the best makeup artist of India. She is the personal makeup artist of Sonam Kapoor. And she has been part of many movies, and she's a great person. So yeah, I was the director of photography at Namrata Soni School of Makeup and Hair, which technically was the main boost in my career. So this happened in 2017. I came back. This was the first time that I was away from home for almost 50 days. So yeah, I came back. I was getting loads and loads of jobs just because I have been a part of such a prestigious institute. I worked with nice people. People who, like, everybody dreams of working with these people. And for me, it was like a piece of cake. Like, I got it served. And so I redeemed as much as I could because I was a part of that team. And in 2018, I joined a course called Mastered. Mastered is a course, is an organization in London, and they only teach about fashion, be it fashion, photography, makeup, styling, art direction, whatever possibilities are there in fashion, they teach about that. So I, as a photographer, enrolled there, and I just enrolled there. I was not sure if I'm going to do it or not because the course fees was super high. I just enrolled it for fun. And they contacted me and they literally convinced me to join because a total of 4,500 photographers apply for this course. 200 are selected. 12 were from India. I was the only one from East India. I did not want to miss this opportunity at all. So I told them that, okay, look, my financial condition is not that stable that I can actually afford you. So I'm really sorry. I really wanted to pursue this course, but I cannot afford that course because I knew it. I won't be able to repay off. So they gave me an offer that instead of 10 months, they offered me a 17 months of repayment plan. The course is for 10 months. So you need to pay off in 10 installments, or you can pay off at one go also. They gave me an option of 17 installments. And I was like, okay, now I think I can afford it, because the fees was 5 lakh rupees for 10 months.
5 lakh? Oh my God.
And this is an online course.
Okay.
There is no certificate involved or nothing as such. It is only the experience. Yeah. So I was like, okay, now since it has been split into 17 months, my per month EMI was something around 29,000 to 30,000.
Yes.
So I was like, okay, that is still manageable. So I joined that course, and they have 3 different sessions throughout the 10 months of, which is called Mastered Live. So the student who has enrolled in a particular batch can attend one of those 3 live sessions. So I attended the live session, which was in Athens in Greece. Greece is beautiful. And I went there. I made a lot of friends. I have friends in almost, like, I have one friend from each country of the world. Yeah, so I made friends, I made contacts, I learned a lot of things. I understood that, okay, India is still a developing country, because in comparison to, say, European countries or, say, American countries, we are way behind fashion industry, like way, way, way behind fashion industry. So I understood things, then I made friends, I made contacts, I came back to India. Now it has been running sort of smoothly. Yeah.
So you've actually worked with Bollywood celebrities, etc.
Yes. Yes. I worked with many Bollywood celebrities, including Sakshi Malik, Karishma Sharma, Paramrata Bhattacharya. Then I don't remember more names.
So you went to Europe also? We were.
Yes. Yeah, Greece is in Europe. I went to Greece for the live session was for 2 days. I went there for 10 days.
Later you went, you got a lot of money. I reckon like 20,000 rupees per hour.
That was during that course only.
Okay.
Like during that particular vacation only.
So you got 20,000 rupees per hour for shooting.
Yeah.
That's a lot of money, boss. 20,000 rupees per
hour. So basically what happens is, in European and American countries, they don't charge, like in India, what happens is they charge on the basis of number of photographs you want, or on the basis of number of outfits you're shooting for. In Europe and America, they charge on hourly basis, because they understand the time value of money. So I charged according to that only, and 20,000 an hour in Greece was still cheaper for them.
Oh.
Because it was hardly lesser than 300 euros. And they are habituated on spending like 500 euros an hour for a photographer. So I was just thinking that, okay, I need to save money. I need to get my whatever I have spent for the travel and accommodation, I need to take that back. Typical Marwadi. So yeah, that's about it.
So typical Marwadi. Now, so if I were to ask, you know, do you really make a decent money where you can convince people at home? Will you get a wife now? Like, how much do you make per annum?
It totally depends. But my last income tax return was for something around 17 lakhs.
17 lakhs from photography? Yeah. That's a lot of money.
But regarding the wife part, I don't want to marry.
No, but you know, you'll have suitors now for that candidature. Now this guy is earning 17 lakh rupees per annum. So it is
No, 17.
15, 16, 17. Uh-huh. 17.
Yeah.
So 17 lakhs per annum. Now, you know, there was a prediction by someone in the family that 10,000 rupees per month kind of a job will be difficult for you as a mere graduate since you are quitting CA now. And now when you go back and tell that, yes, now your efforts have paid off and now you're earning 17 lakh rupees per annum, which is like 1.5 lakh rupees per month. So people would now feel that, yes, art also has its own charm.
Exactly. Had I been continuing CA, I would not have been earning this much amount at all. Plus, I would not have been happy too. This makes me happy.
And what are the low points in the photography career? You know, it cannot happen that everyone who goes for it will make it so big like you. And you've just touched the tip of the iceberg. You know, you've got a long 30 years ahead now. Is it like everyone will succeed? Who will succeed? What are the rules?
It depends how you market yourself, how you behave yourself. Because in this industry, nobody is lesser than somebody who is standing in the front. So we cannot underestimate anyone. And we need to be humble. We cannot have ego issues or attitude issues with a client or with a designer or with a model. You need to stay humble, do your job, give your best, and you'll get work accordingly.
And what is the kind of work people pay for, like pre-wedding shoots, advertisements also?
So basically what happens is, in terms of events, apart from say corporate events or like small birthday parties and those social events, we have like weddings. Weddings is a very big market because Indians tend to spend a lot of money on weddings. Because in India, it is more about showcasing your bank balance, showcasing your power when it comes to a wedding. That, okay, I have been saving for this particular event. Yeah. So they'll be spending a bomb. And so they have like pre-wedding shoots. Then they have this wedding shoot. Many people do a post-wedding photography. So in post-wedding photography, a photographer is appointed who travels with the couple in their honeymoon and they shoot.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So this is about the wedding part. Then after a wedding, when a couple is expecting a child, you have a maternity shoot. Then after the child is born, you have a child photography, baby shower, baby shoot, newborn baby shoot. So that thing is endless. I'm not an expertise in all these things, but yes, I have started wedding photography. I have started pre-wedding photography. I don't do newborn baby shoots. I do maternity photography, but I don't do baby shoots. I hate babies. And regarding fashion,
just 5 lakh rupees also at times. Is it like that? Is it as lucrative a market?
My minimum charges for wedding photography starts from 6.5 lakhs.
Oh my God. Achha.
And this is for a 3-day event.
6.5 lakhs. And there are people who are willing to pay in Calcutta or Bombay?
Yeah. In Calcutta. Bombay, the charges are higher.
Even higher?
Yeah. In Bombay, if you want a good wedding photographer, you need to pay like 7 lakhs per day.
God, so why the hell are we doing all these professional courses? Everyone should jump on if they have the talent.
This is just a glimpse about wedding photography. I'm more into fashion and beauty. So my main clientele are girls, designers, models, makeup artists, stylists. So yeah, I charge accordingly for them. Because obviously they are not going to pay me 6.5 lakhs for 3 days.
10,000 rupees per day, 20,000 rupees per day. That is the kind of...
Yeah, something around that.
Okay. And you recently did a shoot for a European brand. Tell us more about that. Yeah.
So I did a shoot for Ganeshi. They are a leather bag making company from Netherlands. So I did a campaign shoot for them, and it has been like they are marketing their brand all over Europe. And yeah, so that's about it. Like I get photographs from my friends who know that I have been a part of this brand for the shoot purpose. I get photos on WhatsApp that they click the a picture of the hoarding, and they know that I have clicked it because I have a very unique style of lighting and photography, which makes me different from others. So if anyone is following my photography, they can understand from a picture that has it been clicked by Arpit or not.
Specific as that. Okay, yeah. So I sometimes see your Instagram page or your Facebook page and your YouTube. You just started probably. You've got two videos there.
Exactly, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, yeah. So there are unique styles that, okay, this photography, if it is by this lighting and this pattern, it's by this Arpit.
Exactly, exactly. And every photographer has a unique style.
So what would be the way forward for you now in the next 30 years? Like, how would you scale up or something?
I don't know how things are going to work, but I've not planned.
What's the typical path like? So at senior
level, keep working. Just keep working. That's it. Be can humble. Keep working.
Can one get into
film
also? Film shoots and.
I have been given opportunity in films also, but I did not quite like the environment there, because I might be a mere photographer, but I cannot be disrespected or called as a cameraman on sets in front of celebrities. Obviously, they might be getting more attention, but one needs to have their self-respect levels high.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah, that's my personal opinion, but there are people who are willing to work in the movies. They love working in the movies, but I understood one thing that, okay, this is not my cup of tea.
Yeah, so, you know, these are also the flip sides of this industry. So someone, all that talent and you are just called a camera.
Ultimately, it is all about respect.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. It's about respect. So exactly. I think you've really made it at some level in terms of earning, you know, let's say 17 lakh rupees as per your income tax return. And this is just the start, I would say. So what is your message that you would give to future aspirants? You know, a lot of youngsters who are watching this show, generally, I get around 1,000 to 2,000 views on this career conversation theme. So what would be your theme? Let's say someone who's stuck in CA Inter, being told by friends and family, ki bhai, tu padhta kyon nahi hai theek se? Man laga ke padha.
It is not about that. The person who has enrolled or is giving an exam can only understand the pain of the failure. Nobody else can actually understand the pain of the failure.
Yeah.
So if you don't succeed in one particular exam or one particular course, you might not be made for that course, or maybe that was not your time. Either you retry for the course or you give time to yourself, think about what actually makes you happy, and then pursue that course.
Yes,
because I feel that it is never too late to start anything.
Okay.
I technically started photography as my career when I, like, in 2017, I was 24 years old. When I went to Pune, I got an offer to become a faculty member. And before going to Pune, my cousins, my parents, they all told me that, okay, you're going there, but you don't need to join it because you are 24 years old now, and people and the students that are going to be a part of the campus are going to be 17 years or 18 years old who have just cleared their class 12th exams. So if it is a 3-year course, you at the age of 24 is joining this particular course. At the age of 27, you're going to earn, say, 30,000-35,000 rupees a month, and the other students who are going to join are going to be 21, and they are going to be earning that particular amount. So when they come at your age, they are going to be earning a higher amount, and you will be fallen behind. So I somehow find logic in this, but I was not very convinced with it. But obviously things did not work out. I did not become a part of the institute. Nothing stops me from creating good art now. A degree cannot actually define who I really am.
And you call yourself as a chartered accountant without a degree also, no? When people ask for TDS deduction. So
So there are people like corporates and all, they try to fool me. They think that most of them obviously don't know that I am a CA dropout, I am a CS dropout. So they are like, okay, we are going to pay you, but we need to deduct TDS, we need to add GST and all. So we need your GST number. I was like, I'm not eligible for a GST and you cannot deduct my TDS whatsoever. They're like, nahin, karna hoga, we need to do it. I was like, listen, I'm a CA dropout. I know shit. So don't teach me.
Yeah, good. So it's sometimes, you know, efforts always help. So nice.
Exactly.
So I've always interviewed, you know, even partners of Big Four, national heads, CA achievers, MBA achievers. Here is today is the first time I have interviewed someone who got into this course, then went out with his head high into the world of photography, and you've really made it big. So all the best for your venture. And
thank you, sir.
To follow him, they can follow him on Instagram, Arpit Rungta Photography, on Facebook, etc. His YouTube channel has just started. So great, Arpit. Thanks a lot for sparing time for it. I'm sure you're going to rock this world. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Bye.